गुड
आफ्टरनून
आफ्टरनून
मैम. तो टुडे वी बी टॉकिंग विद अ न्यू यूनिट, दैट इज व्हाट इज द न्यू चैप्टर यूनिट थिंग, मल्टी स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ आईसी. तो आईसी स्ट्रेंथ यू विल सी दैट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट यूनिट फॉर योर यू नो नाउ वेरी लॉट्स ऑफ थिंग्स आर डेवलपिंग लाइक रोबोटिक्स then IoT, Internet of Things, and we have many, many block money. So many things are there. So let's see one by one. So over to Vitu, all the best. I have enabled the screen sharing. So first you give an introduction, then you can share.
So today I'm going to take about a seminar on artificial intelligence. First of all, artificial intelligence is a ability of a machine to do like humans, like learning, solving problems, and reasoning. So I am going to say here about some artificial the applications of artificial intelligence in some of our really real life apps, like that things. So about that I'm going to say. So what is artificial intelligence? The artificial intelligence, in that word itself, there are two words. One is artificial and the other is intelligence. Artificial means man-made, that this something is made by a man. And the intelligence means thinking power. So when we combine these words, artificial intelligence means man-made thinking power. So artificial intelligence is the ability of a computer systems or machines to have human-based skills such as learning, reasoning, and solving problems. Or we can also say that artificial intelligence refers to the simulations of human intelligence in machines that are programmed to think like humans and mimic their actions. Advantages. It can do, when we give a decision to a machine, artificial intelligence machine, it can do with high speed the task we have given. And it has high accuracy with less errors. These artificial intelligence machines are used in risky areas, such as bomb defusing, exploring the ocean floor, like which are very dangerous for humans. Applications of artificial intelligence. It is used in natural language processing, manufacturing of robots, and gaming. Machine learning. Machine learning is a subsystem or subfield of artificial intelligence where the machine or the computers have the ability to learn data using statistical techniques which are not explicitly programmed by human beings. These comprises of algorithms that use data to learn on their own and make predictions. These algorithms are called models. So algorithms are first trained and tested, and after successive tests, these machines are able to give results to an acceptable level of accuracy. So they are ready to make predictions of unknown data. That means we are not programming. Like if we need to give an order to that machine that take that book, we are not programming it. So using these algorithms, they are making decisions and they will bring the book. Applications of machine learning. Face recognition. One of the face recognition software is Toshiba Faces Recognition Software. This is it. And second application is self-driving cars like Tesla electric car, which can drive automatically without a driver. Next is natural language processing. It's a technology used by the machines to understand, analyze, manipulate, and interpret human's language. Example is Alexa. We will say to Alexa that play this the song which we wish, and because it understands our language, so it will play that song. It is because of this natural language processing. Components of natural language processing. One is natural language understanding. It's a branch in artificial intelligence that uses the computer software to understand input in the form of sentences in the text. Second one is natural language generation. Natural language generation is the branch of artificial intelligence, which is a software process that automatically transfers data into plain English content. This technology can tell a story by writing sentences and paragraphs. Now, advantages of natural language processing. It helps to get direct response within seconds. It offers exact answers to the questions we asked. NLP helps to communicate with humans in their languages. Applications of natural language processing. It is used in language translation application such as Google Translate. It is also used in personal assistant applications such as Siri, Google Assistant. It is used in Microsoft Word to check the grammatical mistakes in the text we have typed. Next one is immersive experiences. Immersive experiences are experiences which make us feel in a reality, but actually we are not. It allows us to visualize, feel, and react by stimulating our senses. Immersive experiences is now used in game simulator games such as driving simulator and flight simulator and so on. It can be achieved by virtual reality and augmented reality. This is a driving simulator game, the image. Virtual reality. Virtual reality is a simulated experience that can be similar to or completely different from the real world. That means if we will be in the normal reality, like in our house, but we will use some technological devices to be in a different reality. The main device is VR headsets. This is used in playing games such as shooting games. These are the games which are played with VR headsets, and which the reality when we are in a sea. That is the image of second image. Next is augmented reality. Augmented reality is an enhanced version of the real physical world that is achieved through the use of digital visual elements, sound, or other sensory stimuli delivered via technology. That means if we want to put a furniture in the room, so through smartphones or tablets, using some app, we will make a good, perfect position to put that furniture. So it will be good looking for the room and it will be matching. Augmented reality is used in medical training, home interior designing works, and tourism industries. Then the last one is robotics. Robotics is an interdisciplinary field that integrates computer science and engineering, or we can say that it's a combination of computer engineering, mechanical engineering, and electrical engineering. Robotics is used to manufacture robots which assist humans. Robots can be of many types, such as wheeled robots, legged robots, manipulators, and humanoids. Robots that resemble humans are known as humanoids. Robots are now used in risky situations such as bomb detecting, inspection of radioactive materials in armies, and it is also used in where human cannot survive, such as space, underwater, and places with high temperature. This is the image of a wheeled robot, and second one is a legged robot, and third one is a drone. Drones are used to transport materials within short distances and for aerial photographies, and like that, many uses are there with the drones, and it is also an artificial intelligence product. That's all. Thank you.
Excellent. Everyone unmute and please have a round of applause. It was very nice. We learned a lot, isn't it? Nevin, why Nevin, you are smiling because it's next is it your turn? Take this in now. Yeah. See, and so these are the topics you have to study, even though Vito's has taken such a way that it is like a general topic, but it is included in your syllabus. So that these topics will be coming for your examination. So before, what you can do is we just save it in a PDF format. Okay, PDF format and send to that homework group. So that is, we'll take it as a tutorial, not for that particular chapter. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Then who's the next? Who's next? Test screen is enabled. You can give an introduction, or you can share.
Good afternoon, everyone. Today I'm here to present a topic on big data. So did anyone know what is this big data? So I'm going to share my screen. Hope you are able to see my screen. I think hope you all are able to see my screen. So yeah, I'm here. I'm here to take the topic big data. Big data means it consists of, so these are the contents what I am going to take, big data and its characteristics. So big data means it refers to a huge volume of data that cannot be stored or processed by any traditional data storage or processing units. From that itself, we can understand that it consists of a large volume of data that cannot be stored by any other processing units or data storage. As these types of data has been used by the multinational companies for improving their organization or businesses. So this big data has some other characteristics. These include volume, variety, value, velocity, and veracity. And in this veracity, there has been another name for that, that is the variability. So the first one is the volume. Volume means it refers to the unimaginable amounts of information which is generated from every second from social media, like cell phones, cars, credit cards, M2M sensors, images, video, and whatnot. Which means from when we used to search, as we all know that every people in this world has been used to search something on Google. So there has been million times a day that people used to search something on Google. So that unimaginable amounts of information has been generated by this type of volume data. And cell phones, credit cards, M2M sensors. M2M sensors means this emission to machine sensors, which means there will be no interfacing or interaction with the people. For example, M2M sensors, it is ATM. And another examples of volume is images, video, and whatnot. And in volume, we know that different countries have been using distributed systems. For example, in a country like America, they have been using the systems belonging to their data. They have been storing their data belonging to that systems. So they bring all together in a software that is called Hadoop. So that's about volume. And when we take in the case of Facebook, we can say that in Facebook, millions of people have been posting millions of pictures, or we know that in like button, there has been millions of sharing has been recorded each day. So this type of huge amount of data can only be handled by big data technologies. So that's all about the volume. Volume, it's symbol, which means that it refers to the unimaginable amounts of data which has been generated from social media. Example, cell phones, cards, credit cards, etc. And the next one is variety. Variety means it refers to structured, unstructured, and semi-structured. Structured means it will be in the form of a table. For example, the form of a rows in a SQL database. So that means in the case of a structured, and unstructured means it will be this in either will be in the form of human or in the textual form. It means contains large volume of data that will be in the form of textual format, or will be human generated. So that's mean by unstructured. And semi-structured or half structured means like that both elements like structured and unstructured has been coming in the semi-structured, which means in that semi-structured, when we take in the example of a email, we know that email is an unstructured data, but the things which have been used to send an email, we know that in email, the name, address, and recipient. So these all are the structured. And in when we take in the example of a digital photograph, the photo or the image is an unstructured, but the date and time or tags is an structured data. So that means in the case of a semi-structured. So this data has been gathered from multiple sources like images, videos, or photographs. So these are different from each other. That is mean by here, variety of big data refers to structured, unstructured, and semi-structured data that is gathered from multiple sources. While in the past, the data could only be collected from spreadsheets. As we know, in the past, there has been only data has been stored in the form of spreadsheet or database. But now we have been storing the data in the form of PDF, audio, or video files, or in the case of emails. So that's all about variety. And the value means It is not the amount of data that we store or process. It is the actually the amount of the valuable or reliable and trustworthy data that needs to be stored, processed, and analyzed to find insights. Which means we should only store the data like it should be reliable. As we know that like cash or term, these are not the data which we can trust. So these types of data couldn't be stored. That means here in the case of a value. As the actual amount of valuable, reliable, and trustworthy data that needs to be stored and processed and analyzed to find insights. So that means the case of value. And next is the velocity. As we all know, what does velocity means? It means like velocity, it means the mean speed of generation of data, which means that no one is like to wait for something like for the data. For example, when we used to search something on Google, we need that in speed. That means here that the user will not be waiting for the things that had been searched. So that means in the case of velocity. For example, when we take in the case of YouTube, we know that 72 hours of video are uploaded to YouTube every minute. So we can see that when we try to retrieve something, a video on YouTube, it will get as time as faster. So that means here in the velocity. And next is the veracity or variability. It means it refers to the inconsistency. As we all know, what does inconsistency means? Which means there will sometimes will happen in a wrong data or like this can be shown by the data many times, thus hampering the process to handle and manage the data effectively. For example, we can say table here, but in this table, some data or values have been missing. So sometimes there can be a chance for, or it may be difficult for the user to trust, or it may sometimes may get messy. So when there is sometimes we'll be having some kind of wrong data. So it might be difficult to trust. So that's mean here in the case of veracity or variability. So in this example, we can take in the example of a Twitter. Twitter post has hashtags and abbreviations. For example, when we take in the case of two social medias, that is Instagram and Twitter. In Instagram, you know that when you have been putting the hashtags relating to the post by the user. But in Twitter, sometimes the hashtags becoming an error. So that means here in the case of veracity or variability, sometimes it may become a difficulty to trust or it may have a wrong data. So in the Instagram, the user has been putting the hashtags for the post relating to it. But in Twitter, sometimes it may be an error. Maybe the user has not been entered the hashtags, but it will become in the form of hashtags as a wrong data, as a wrong entry. So that means in the case of veracity or variability. So these are the pictures of big data. So that's all about my topic, big data. Hope you all have been understood. Is there any doubt?
Any doubt? Hello. Very good. Very good presentation. Wonderful. Unmute everyone. So again to you also, the same thing. Change it to a PDF and send to the group. Okay, so big data. So that is a big thing for you to study. That's the emerging technology, as you know, this hard disk capacity, it won't be enough to save your videos, which will be uploaded. You can't imagine how many videos will be uploaded in the YouTube app. So it uses another technology that is called big data. So you just have to know only the introduction part. First, you will study later if you have. We are taking computer science as the main subject. All right. Next is IoT. Let us. All the best.
Good afternoon to everyone. I'm going to present Internet of Things or computing infrastructure. Internet of Things, it's an integrated system of interrelated computing devices which are provided with unique identifiers, and it has an ability to transfer data over a network without requiring human-to-human or human-to-computer interaction. Over here, it's like this can communicate with each other in order to perform a special task, whatever it may be. We don't need to interact with them. The Internet of Things can make everyday devices smarter by giving the ability to send data over the internet, allowing the device to communicate with the people and other IoT-enabled devices. And how these work is with the help of sensors. There are many sensors in these devices, some for checking the temperature, some for blood pressure, humidity. It depends on what the use is. For example, if you're going home, what's it say? If you need to know the weather outside, you would have a thermometer. And if you want to know the orientation of your phone and stuff, like, you know, see. The next topic is cloud computing. Cloud computing is on-demand delivery of IT resources over the internet with pay-as-you-go pricing. The companies that provide cloud services enable the users to store files, applications on remote servers, and then access all the data via the internet. In cloud computing, there's an application for Google Stadia where you can play games on anything that has a screen. For example, if you have a tablet or a smartphone, you can directly stream it with the help of internet to access those games. They'll be making you pay a subscription amount, and you can access any game, whether it may be a very high, what is it? Whether it may be a high GB game or something, it does not matter how much RAM you have. You just need a screen to broadcast to it, and your controls will be sent to the main supercomputer. Types of cloud. Public cloud. It has publicly shared virtualized resources, which supports multiple customers, supports connectivity over the internet, suited for less confidential information. Example, Gmail. Private cloud, privately shared virtualized resources, clusters of dedicated customers, connectivity over the internet, fiber, and private network. Suited for secure confidential information and core systems. Example, Amazon Web Service. Types of cloud computing. Cloud computing is not a single piece of technology like a microchip or a cell phone. Rather, it's a system primarily comprised of three services: software as a service, infrastructure as a service, and platform as a service. Software as a service involves the licensure of software application to customers. Licenses are typically provided through pay-as-you-go model or on-demand. As software as a service utilizes the internet to deliver applications which are managed by a third-party vendor to its vendor and its users. A majority of software as a service application runs directly through a web browser. Infrastructure as a service involves a method of delivering everything from operating systems to servers and storage through IP-based connectivity as a part of an on-demand service. Clients can avoid the need to purchase a software or servers and instead procure these resources in an outsourced on-demand service from a cloud provider. Popular examples of IaaS system include IBM Cloud and Microsoft Azure, Amazon Web Services, etc. Platform as a service. It is considered as the most complex of the three layers of cloud-based computing. Platform as a service shares some similarity with software as a service. The primary difference being that instead of delivering the software online, it is actually a platform for creating software that's delivered via the internet. Grid computing. Grid computing is a group of computers physically connected over a network with internet to perform dedicated tasks together, such as analyzing e-commerce data and solve a complex problem. That's a form of a super virtual computer that solve a particular application. Blockchain technology. It is a simple analogy for understand blockchain technology as a Google Doc, which I've been using to showing you guys the slides. When we create a document and share with a group of people, the document is distributed instead of being copied or transferred. Thank you.
it was a very wonderful performance, Devi. Why? What happened? Thank you. Bye.